If the shoe fits, two Cinderella stories retold by Pleasant DeSpain. Cinderella named Zoe. Once, not long ago, there was a girl named Zoe. She loved school, especially math, PE, and science. Her stepbrother Finn enjoyed it playing tricks on Zoe. One day, their mother tried logging onto her laptop, but her password wasn't accepted. Finn, did you change my password? No, Mom. Try Zoe's password. It worked. Zoe, cried their mother, you know the rule. You can't use my computer without permission. Instead of going to Randall's party tomorrow, you'll do Finn's chores and mow the lawn. But, Mom, I didn't. Laughing, Finn went outside. Randall had invited all of his friends to his birthday party. His mom was baking a delicious chocolate cake. He hoped Zoe would come. She was one of his best friends. The next day, Finn and their mom left for Randall's party. The doorbell rang. It was Zoe's favorite neighbor, Mrs. Fortuna. She always sparkled. Want to go to the party? How did you know? I have a few secrets, dear. But the lawn, began Zoe. Mrs. Fortuna pulled bright red garden shears from her bag. To Zoe's amazement, the shears flew out of Mrs. Fortuna's hands. The lawn was mowed in seconds. Zoe was thrilled. She ran to get her favorite shoes, but Finn had hidden them. What will I wear? Mrs. Fortuna handed her a pair of golden tennis shoes. Zoe thought they were superb. On the way to Randall's house, one of Zoe's shoes came untied and tumbled onto the street. It was run over by a bus. My shoe, yelled Zoe. Mrs. Fortuna consoled her. Two shoes don't make wishes come true. Randall beamed when Zoe walked in. He invited her to sit next to him. Noticing her one shoe, he thought, this is something new. And then he said, cool, everyone take off one shoe, just like Zoe. It was time to cut the cake. The candles were lit, and before Randall blew them out, Zoe smiled. One of her wishes had come true. A Cinderella Named Kwan, a Korean story. Long ago, a baby girl was born. Her father named her Kwan, which means strong. Sadly, her mother died. Years later, Kwan's father remarried. His new wife had her own daughter named Ki, which means pleasure. Kwan's stepmother and stepsister were jealous of Kwan and unkind to her. One beautiful spring morning, Kwan's stepmother said, I'm taking Ki to the festival. Can I go, honorable mother? Asked Kwan. Yes, but first you must weed the garden. Ki and her mother laughed as they left for the city. Kwan's heart was heavy. The garden was filled with weeds. She went outside and was surprised by a large brown cow who said, I'll eat the weeds. Yes, please, Kwan said. The cow chomped all the weeds in a flash. Suddenly, a flock of songbirds appeared in the sky, carrying a lovely robe and slippers. For the strong one, they sang. Thrilled, Kwan dashed down to the road of the bridge, crossing the river. She tripped and fell. One of her slippers splashed into the water. Oh, no, cried Kwan, watching the slipper float away. Kwan hobbled home and hid the gown and slipped in an old trunk. Meanwhile, a young prince was traveling to the festival. Thirsty, he stopped by the river for a drink. He put his lips into the cold, rushing water, and a beautiful slipper floated by. Pretty slipper, pretty lady? He asked as he grabbed the slipper. Pretty lady, sang the birds flying above. I must find her, he declared. The prince traveled to many farms, asking every young woman to try on the slipper. Arriving at Kwan's farm, he showed it to He and Kwan. He shoved Kwan to the side, saying, It's mine. You are not polite, said the prince. Your sister will try first. Kwan slipped her foot into the slipper. You are strong and beautiful, he said. Please marry me. Smiling, Kwan said, yes. The songbirds swirled above. Happy was their song.